guy from a different background. And I thought to me, they didn't shoot him on the green, so I can't cheat it. So what I need to do is create a mask. The mask will make it very perfect, and then move on to the next frame, and I have to just change the mask each single frame. And 10 seconds means 250 times when you can change the whole mask. So, rotoscoping isn't a very nice job. I hate that. And it took me hours to get this guy from out of the bag. So now that After Effects really make this process easier, and we introduced the new roller brush tool. Just double click him to enter the layer mode here. And the roller brush tool is very easy to use because I just have to drag over the foreground to make a selection. So let's go in there and say, okay, I want the head and I want the shoulder. And you can now see After Effects calculate and create a selection. It's just a single stroke. I want some more, so let's move on there. Select that kind of area here. We just have to select this a little bit. And just to make clear where the edge is. So, just a few clicks, I have a selection on that guy. Just like the complex selection tool in Photoshop, but now we are moving it over time. So let's see what happens when I move my time indicator. I just move it a little bit to the right. And you can see that my selection falls. Because I forgot here the small thing, so I just adjust a little bit. And if I don't want to include specific areas, I just hit my Alt key, paint over that, to tell After Effects which areas it don't should include in the selection. So now let's move on to this section, and you can see After Effects just calculates and moves the mask. And when his hand comes out, very good. But let's move in the other direction. So you can see here I start creating my map. Now let's move a little forward, and you can see what happens here. After Effects forgot the selection like that, so I just have to reconfigure it a little bit. Tell After Effects, bring that into the selection, go a little bit in the front, and sometimes he starts moving his head out of the screen, coming into the screen. Here you go. So I just have to tell After Effects that it should recalculate over there. So from there, we move his head. I just hit the Alt key again for After Effects to not include the head into the selection. And I move back in time. Just telling After Effects what I like and what I don't like. So it's very easy with a few paint strokes. I can just create a perfect selection of that guy in the foreground. And it doesn't matter what kind of background you have. So there could be people in the background. There could be so much more. And you don't need to shoot on green screen to use the new roller brush tool. But there's a few more things here. The roller brush tool allows you, it has so many settings. I could go now through all these settings, but we will get in deep. I want to, but please, later on I will show you more settings on the roller brush tool. So I will just show you how you can work that. I go back to my composition. You can see it is now put on black here. And I just want to drag a new part in the background. And here we go, we change the background as one single rotoscoping brush tool, and it takes you so much time using the new work. Okay. So, that is, I think, the most interesting thing in After Effects. Let's move on to Premiere Pro. And last year, I started with HD footage, so I was a little bit disappointed for the performance. So let's say we want to have traditional ABC HD video, and we add a couple of tracks to it, and then the video playback is not very smooth. Because Premiere Pro doesn't use the graphic acceleration, the acceleration of the graphic card, it doesn't use the iCore 7, all that CPU cost that we have, and that makes it a little bit slower. But right now, in Premiere Pro CS5, we are just focusing on three new things. First, performance. Second, performance. And guess what the third thing is? Performance as well. So, it's really all about performance. And let me show you a few things what that means. And I think you won't believe what you can do in your thought. So, let's go on a sequence. And I have, right in there, 9 layers of HD footage with multiple effects. Go to my effect control. You can see I have a crop effect. I have color correction effect somewhere over there. have motion effect that change capacity value. And 9 laps of HD video, and let's just play off. Isn't that great? But hold on, let's add some more. So I'll look for a specific clip right there. Go to my April performance. And I want to have that. So I put it on a new layer, a channel layer here. Let's scale it a little bit down. You know, it plays back in real time because all the stuff in the background is not visible. But I will introduce you to the new CUDA accelerated effect. So why it doesn't play back in real time? Because we use graphic card acceleration. So all these effects are now played back via the GPU. So my CPU has a lot of space just for exporting and stuff like that, because everything you see is rendered through the GPU, and we use CUDA acceleration on the NVIDIA graphic card. So I use the new Ultra key to get rid of the green. So here's the Ultra key. Just drag and drop it on that guy. Over here right now, and I say the key color should be something like that. So wow. Like that, and you should see keying on 9 different layers of video in real time in your time. That's amazing, right? But maybe we have to go into the resolve and just change a little bit, because you can see there's some green spill. I need to crop it a little bit. So let's choose my crop effect and crop the left and right edges a little bit. And we can percent from the left to the right edge. Okay, so we call it back. And then let's change the tolerance here of 1099. Looks not so good. That's what we'll set. Okay, so increase the light. And now you have a perfect selection of the green screen. What normally you used to do that in After Effects, because the Kira and previous versions of the Pro just give you so much better control, like the new Ultra key. But now watch that. We have a 9 layers of video, plus the keying effect, all playing back in real time. You don't have to render, you don't have to wait, it is just that you see it. And if you want, you can even go to show it on maximize frame here, play it back in real time. And if you have a second monitor, you can see the HD result of the live here playing back in real time. So it's all about performance in the video code CS5. Thank you.